Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, today I just want to do a very simple, very quick little CAD demonstration. I've got some friends that are looking to draw some things, and they don't have a few thousand dollars to shell out on AutoCAD. There's a program called CAD Standard, and they've got a free version, which will have up to 7 colors. The full-blown version that has the 15 colors and all the special features and everything is only about $40. Very worthwhile, very good program for what it is. So, let's say, for example, we were going to draw something, I don't know, like a travel trailer, for example, and we wanted to lay down different aspects of it. We can go in here and do all the settings ourselves. We can use this, which is a pre-existing kind of thing for converting drawings, or we can use their drawing scale expert. I'm going to select to do that. So we tell it next, and now what we're presented with is a couple of selections. First, you can figure out how big you want to make your plot. So, you know, you want to do some uber detailed thing on 34 by 44 inches, you can do that. If you just want to do a little sketch on 8.5 by 11 paper, you can do that too. Then you can come in here and you can select whether you want to go with feet and inches, strictly inches, feet with decimal, etc., metric. I would say for most of you, start off, if you're doing something larger than, say, a sheet of paper, use feet and inches. If you're using something, let's say, 24 by 36, something that fit on a CAD, on a CNC machine or something, then just use engineering inches. But for right now, we're going to use architect. So let's say we've got this travel trailer, and we expect this thing with all the parts and everything to be about 25 feet wide, long, and, you know, 10 feet, you know, wide. So what we can do is we can come in here, we can tell it 25, and then put the foot mark, and then this way, tell it, 10 feet. And it will do all the magic that it needs to do to create a paper size large enough to hold it. The next thing you'll want to do is you want to go to your settings, and you want to set up the grid. It usually tries to come up with what it thinks is a good grid size, but it's never correct. So since we're going to do things in feet and inches, I want them to line up on a convenient foot mark. So what I'm going to do to start off with is I'm going to tell it 1 foot increments. So just put 1 foot. Now you see I've got these lovely little grids and they're all spaced 1 foot apart. Now let's say I want to outline the shell of our camper. I'm going to pick a layer which is going to be our shell. I'm going to pick number 12, a medium gray. Why? I don't know. I feel like it. Up here you've got different tools. So you can draw circles and arcs and ellipses and all kinds of wonderful things. Right here is a rectangle. So I can come over here and I can click and you'll see how it locks in on the grids. And I can draw a rectangle. Well, rather than me try and figure out what that is, I can just come down here and say, hey, I know what this is. I can tell you unequivocally this thing is 18 feet by 10 feet. And then just hit enter. And you've got a perfectly sized rectangle. Yay for us. And let's say you want to prove that it's a perfectly sized rectangle. We can pick a color for our dimensions. Let's say we want to put dimensions on there. We'll use red. Okay? You can come up here and you see there's these little dimension marks. So I want to do some vertical dimension. I can click on it, click this spot, come off, and you see it says it's 10 feet. I can use a horizontal. I can click here. I can click here. I can come down. And it says it's 18 feet, all nice and pretty and marked out, and it's going to fit on our paper very well. So now let's say I want to go inside here, and I want to do some more details. But now I'm going to go down to a 6-inch level, let's say. So I'm going to go to my grid, and I'm going to say I want to go every 6 inches. Set my accuracy for 6 inches. And you can set it for whatever you need. But now you see we've doubled the amount of grid points. So we zoom in by using the mouse wheel to zoom in. Or you can use these little tools here, for example. You can center it on a window. You can zoom to a window. So if I click on this and then I go like this, it will zoom it into that window. I like to use the mouse wheel, but yeah, you can do whatever you like. So here's your camper, and now you want to draw some stuff in there, let's say. So we've used this color to represent the walls. We'll use another color to represent something else. Say, for example, we want to put in some sheetrock, and we want to do something like that. And we want to come over here, and we say, you know, we want to make this little wall that goes from here. Oop, I got to tell it to make a line. Polyline. So I want to draw a line from here like this, and I want to come over here like this, and I want to put that in there. Now you see that I can right click and that'll end that command. And let's say I wanted this to be a bathroom. I wanted to show that there's a sink over here of a certain size. I can click a rectangle, and let's say I don't want to put it there right now. I'm just, you know, sketching, right? So I come over here and I say, you know what, this thing is 3 feet wide by 2 feet. I can go 3 feet by 2 feet, and it'll make it, but obviously I don't want it here. I want it over here. You come over here, there's a little tool, says move. I can pick this guy like this. Then what you do is you pick a point on it, and it says move to, and I say I want to move it right up here to this corner. Boom, it's in that corner now. And then right click to finish the command. And so you can see that we've got that little sink over here. Now say we needed to offset it some more, say down at the inch level. I can come into the grid and I can tell it, hey, I need more detail. I need a grid every 1 inch. All right, and now I can zoom in and you see I've got even more details. I can say, hey, I need to move this guy again. Right click to tell it I'm finished selecting items and say move it from here to here. All right, right click to finish the command. And now what I can do is I can zoom back out. I can use minus here to zoom out. Go back to my settings. Set my grid back to every 6 inches. And I can continue. And you can draw these different layers in, get everything going on and stuff. Now, we put some dimensions in here. Let's say, for example, you're tired of looking at them. You don't want to see those dimensions right now. We did those in red, so I can go over here and right-click and turn them off. Haven't deleted them. They're still there. You can turn them on and off. And that can be really handy if you want to make some notes to yourself about where things are. So I can turn this on. I can set my grid to as exact as I want to get. All right, zoom way in here, and I want to put in a horizontal measurement from here. Oh, now I see I'm on a different color. Hit escape, go to my color, go to my grid. And you can tell it, you know, exactly what you want to do, what your spacing is. 3 foot 10 inches is what our space is there. And then, you know, if you're drawing stuff and that kind of thing is going to get into your way, then you know, you can always right click on here and turn those dimensions off. Now it won't let me do it right now because red is the current color that I have selected, but as soon as I select another color, another layer, then I can go ahead and turn that one off. So basically this is, you know, some of the functions of this CAD program. It's really good. It takes you a little while to get used to it, but once you do, it's really nice. Then what you can do is you can come over here to File. You can go Save As, and it'll ask you for a name. You give it a name, and you can save it. One of the nice things I like about this program is that you can do an export. And you can export to SVG, which means that you can then bring it into something like Inkscape and turn it into a drawing and shade it and color it and make it look all pretty. PostScript, so you can kick it out to a high-resolution printer. It will let you do a PDF so you can share it with somebody that doesn't have a CAD program. HPGL, I haven't really used it too much. Some printers will accept it. And DXF. Now, DXF is very useful if you've got a CNC machine and you've got programs to convert CAD files into G-code, because DXF is very popular. And then just hit continue. It'll ask you where you want to save it, and you can save it. Very handy. Also, this program will import a DXF. So when you go to open a file, one of the things that you can do is you can select a DXF as your input source, in addition to the, you know, the CAD's own format and some of these graphics printer formats. But having this ability to import a DXF is really handy, because you can import something that somebody drew in AutoCAD, let's say, save it out in this, and then tweak it up to suit your needs. That's all I'm going to cover on this little tutorial. Later on, if there's an interest, if there is, drop something down in the comments, and I'll go through some of the other things, doing mirrors and moving things around and making multiple copies, things of that nature. But thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it.